Camp Caribe is a year-round Christian camp, and we're divided into three main areas of ministry. We've got our rentals, which is mostly for local groups, local churches that come in to put on retreats. We've got the summer camps, our programs. So we do retreats that we put on throughout the year. We do summer camps, 3 weeks of summer camp for youths of all ages. And then we've also got the mission adventure teams, which is the mission teams that come down to serve here at camp and also in the community.
It's been over 9 months since Hurricane Maria swept over Puerto Rico, but you can still see the devastation. The power lines that are knocked over, the amount of roofs that are still missing, the cement that is crumbling from sitting underwater for so many months. Here at Camp Caribe, they just got power back to the camp last week.
We lost a lot of roofs around here. Anything that was basically a metal roof, a metal awning. A lot of the paint on the buildings was damaged. That's something that we've been doing this week. We cannot keep this camp open and serve the people that we serve without the help of the mission teams that come down to help us with our facilities.
I woke up this morning, saw a world full of trouble. Now I thought, how do we ever get so far down, and how's it ever gonna
turn? One of the biggest things that we want to instill in groups is we want them to have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ if they do not already have that. And if they do, we want them to grow in some way, shape, or form while they're down there. Yes, the work that we're doing is important, but it's not about the work. It's more about the bonding experience. It's about the attitude that you have while you're doing that. And it's about growing together as a team, growing closer to the Lord.
We made it. We're here in Puerto Rico. We're ready to go.
That is ultimately what we are hoping. That's what our vision is for the mission teams, is to give you an outlet to be able to serve the Lord and to grow with each other while you're doing that.
We're down here in Puerto Rico for the week, staying at Camp Caribe on the south side of the island. The purpose of the trip is kind of twofold. One, we're here to help our Puerto Rican brothers and sisters as they rebuild from the hurricane. And then the other part of that is we watch our kids and our team grow as well as we do the work done. This year I feel like our team has been extra special. To be able to see the relationships form and how quickly they formed together was not typical. The way that our kids have gelled together as a team, the way that they have jumped into hanging out with kids at club and doing work projects, especially in the heat and the humidity, without complaining, has been so cool to see.
So Camp Caribe mission trips are actually good for as young as middle school, high school groups, college groups, even families or mixed groups. So basically what happens when we have mission teams come down, if they're working here at the camp, it's to help us improve our facilities, maintain our facilities. We've got a lot of space here, a lot of buildings, a lot of beds, and so we cannot keep this camp open and serve the people that we serve without the help of the mission teams that come down to help us with our facilities. Sometimes we also have mission teams that work with our summer camps, help us put on retreats, but everything that we have is geared towards our mission statement. And our mission statement is to glorify God by impacting people through Jesus Christ to change their worlds. So the idea is that no matter who you are when you come here to camp, you're gonna be impacted through Jesus Christ. You're either going to have an opportunity to have a relationship with Him if you don't already, or you're gonna grow in that relationship with Him. So that then once you go back to your home, to your world, to your community, you can have an impact there as well.
For me as a youth pastor, it's incredibly encouraging and inspiring when I see our kids connect with the Puerto Rican kids. Regardless of the language barrier or age difference, playing is universal. And to see our kids step out of their comfort zones and engage with these kids it's incredible. It's incredible to see what it does to our kids, and it's incredible to see what it does to the Puerto Rican kids as well.
You cannot hide the light. Whom shall I fear? You crush the enemy underneath my feet.
boys were kind of just hesitant. They're kind of sitting in the corner, just hanging out.
Once we started playing basketball, we just kind of all mixed together, and it didn't matter that we couldn't speak the same language because we all just had a good time together.
It was really cool to see like the kids who were kind of hesitant to even like talk to us at the beginning. By the end, they wanted to play with us and like be on our team.
Impacted me hanging out with those kids so much was that what I've been through, I didn't know why God put me in those situations until now. And I had a very, very special moment with one of the kids, and God was telling me, Bert, there's a chance right there. And I kind of opened up to him and told him what I've been through. After that, he actually teared up, which made me want to tear up too. So that kind of opened my eyes to see why God put me in Puerto Rico right now is to help those kids. And I finally realized that, you know, I have to tell these kids my story.
I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side.
We spend majority of our time down here working, but we do get some free time as well. And when you're on a Caribbean island, there's a lot of fun things to do.
One time, one world, two times, one love.
We've gotten to do some fishing out here in the Caribbean. We've also got to do a whole bunch of swimming. We get to go cliff jumping. And the best part about all of that is just the bond that it creates. When everybody's out in the ocean and somebody gets knocked over by a wave, or you're reeling in a big fish, or maybe you're just taking a walk on a beach. And what's really cool is we see the dynamics of our adults and our teenagers starting to bond together across the generations.
It's about a week-long trip. Most teams come from Saturday to Saturday. Sunday is more of a relaxed day. We go to church. We go out and just kind of see the island a little bit. Normally, Monday through Thursday are work days, and that's a combination of work projects here at the camp, out in the community, getting involved in some local ministries like the after-school center that my wife runs in the barrio. And then Friday, we normally do at least one day off where we get to go see more of the island, visit a beach, visit a river, do some kind of a fun day, and then Saturday is the day that teams normally travel back. So throughout that time, we do things like morning devotions, eat meals together, do life together, and it's a good experience.